Good evening, everybody. Welcome to Vision Church. We are hosting Encounter Night tonight. I just wanted to acknowledge some of the other churches in the room. We've got Stephen S. Where are you from, Steve? Covenant Love Community. We got Steve Bellamy, who's from Auburn. We've got well, the rest of us are Vision Church people here. We got some other churches in the room tonight. Christ Community. What do we got? I see some hands going up. Who's that? New Life from Endicott. Praise God. Listen, we are the body of Christ. We are the church. It's not about you and me. It's always been about Jesus. I'm going to come up in front a little bit here. So listen, the way we're doing things tonight, this is an interactive service. The goal is for us to build some unity with the churches and really go for more, okay? So the goal is here is that we're drawing near according to the promises of Scripture. That if you draw near to me, I will draw near to you. And so that requires us to be transparent, real, vulnerable. That requires us to put aside distractions, tastes, preferences, differences, even, you know, theological, you know, I don't like that stuff, confrontation. We just want more of the Lord because he fixes all of that. And so tonight as we seek Jesus and make this about Jesus, I just want to challenge you to go for the more. We're going to be praying for people tonight. There might be some prayers or some challenges that go out where we're sensing that the Holy Spirit wants to do something in the room with somebody or with all of us. And so we're going to be praying for people over here. And I'll be in the back. And so if you want prayer for anything, or if you feel that you have something that maybe is for the whole group here tonight, something's on your heart stirring up, you're not sure what to do with it, but you just feel like this prompt in your heart that God has something in you for somebody else, come see me in the back, and we'll test it. Nobody's going to get rebuked and judged and all that stuff. We're just going to walk this out with grace and truth and be real and try to be the body of Christ, because he says that as each one does his share, causes the growth. So that means if I'm doing everything, we're not growing. If these guys are doing everything, we're not growing. We all need to be participating, okay? So tonight is a participatory service. So if something happens with worship and you find that there's no words, don't get annoyed. They might be singing something that we haven't even planned, okay? Just go with it. Try to focus on Jesus and put aside distractions. Take your petitions, let the Lord know what's on your heart, give those things away and allow him to take control and do something with them. Amen. So I think I covered everything. All right. So Lord Jesus, we invite you. This is your house. These are your people. This is your bride. And we just ask for the Holy Spirit. We command any other spirit to go. We declare that Jesus is King and Lord and rules in this place, and that we are his people. And we say, have your way here, Jesus. Have your way here. Bring us closer to the Father. Help us see him. Help us feel him. Help us be changed tonight. That all fear, anxiety be stripped away, and let the peace of God rule over our hearts and minds tonight. In Jesus' name.
God thinks it was just so cool. So I just echo everything that Nate said and just be open to whatever God wants to do. And so here we go. One, two, one, two, three. Thank you.
Corinthians 3. I once thought these things were valuable, but now I consider them worthless because of what Christ has done. Yes, everything else is worthless when compared to the infinite value of knowing Christ Jesus, my Lord. For his sake, I have discarded everything else, counting it all as garbage, so that I could gain Christ and become one with him. I no longer count on my own righteousness through obeying laws. Rather, I become righteous through faith in Christ. I want to know Christ and experience the mighty power that raised him from the dead. I want to suffer with him, sharing in his death, so that one way or another, I will experience the resurrection. I must know this man. I must have more. This is not enough. I have a promise that if I will seek him, I will find him. That if I search with him all my heart, mind, soul, and strength, that I will gain him. Because everything else is garbage. He is the precious gift of heaven.
Just listening to what Pastor Nate was saying, and just as he was beginning to share, I was looking through the scriptures to find this particular verse in Romans 12, verse 1. It says, I beseech you, therefore, brethren, by the mercies of God, that you present your bodies a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your reasonable service. And I was actually, as we were spending time praising, I think oftentimes we consider that to be worship, but it's actually that God is looking for us to present our bodies as that worship, that we're a living sacrifice, and that we're inviting his presence. You know, we're two or three are gathered, there he is in the midst. And we were singing about Holy Spirit earlier. And I think when we invite the presence of God and Holy Spirit begins to move in our hearts as we're praising, I think that what that spiritual service of worship does, it begins to form in our hearts. We begin to realize who God has made us to be and how he is calling us into that continual sacrifice, that death, that we count all this other is rubbish for the greater knowledge of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And so at any rate, I just feel like the Holy Spirit wants us to be willing to let him move in our hearts, and if we haven't received, yes, and be that sacrifice for Jesus' sake.
He was also sensing, if you've not received the baptism of the Holy Spirit, as explained through the book of Acts and in Corinthians, it's a gift of the Holy Spirit. It's not something you can conjure up. It's something available to all Christians. And so if that's you, if you've never received that, if you don't have the gift of the speaking in tongues, we'd like to pray for you. You're going to have to take a step of faith and ask the Lord for what he has promised to give. And And so modeling scripture, we see they laid hands on them and prayed for them. And so if that's you and you want that, I just challenge you to come to the back and we'll pray with you.
Lord, you
couple people here tonight, and you love Jesus, you do your best, you try to serve him, you try to honor him, you've done things in his name, you've tried to be the church. And I feel like I'm supposed to ask you a question, which is, what would it look like if you said, God, you can have your way, you can have it all. What would it look like if you truly surrendered everything, if you put everything on the table, if you put all of your options on the table and said, God, take everything that needs to go away and give me only what you want. Because you've been coming with half measures. You've been giving him portions. And he wants it all. He wants it all. He died for all of you, not pieces of you. And he didn't give you pieces of himself. He gave you his entire being. But you've been holding back, because you're concerned about what he might do. And so I'm confronting the lie right now that says, maybe he's not good. Maybe he'll take away the good things that I have. Those are lies. Tonight, lay it all down and give him reign and let him send you where he wants. Let him take what he wants. Because he's going to then give you what you never could give yourself. If that's you, later, you just come back. I'll pray with you and we'll just seal that in faith. May our worship rise to you, Lord, tonight as incense. As sweet-smelling fragrance, may we be the sacrifice, God. May we be the offering.
scripture has been going in my head throughout the time here, and I really believe that God wants to know that He's good, and He doesn't change. The world around us is changing, but Jesus is the Word made flesh, and He never changes. The standard of His Word never changes. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. We can count on Jesus. We can stand on Him as our rock. That is just awesome. He is our cornerstone.
Hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest faith, but wholly trust in Jesus' name. With trumpet sound, oh, may I then in him be found. Dressed in his righteousness alone, called to stand before Christ alone, cornerstone, he came strong.
resting in Him. No performance, no pressure. Only one person to impress tonight. Only one person we're singing to.
feel like we are actually in heavenly places right now, in Jesus. And you know, as we're singing this, it was like it just resonated in my heart. This Revelation 5, where it says, "Oh, let me see, where do I want to start?" And so I wept much because there was none worthy to open and read the scroll. And as I at the light, I need some light. Okay. But one of the elders said to me, "Do not weep. Behold, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the Root of David, has prevailed to open the scroll and to loose the seven seals." And I looked, and behold, in the midst of the throne and of the four living creatures, and in the midst of the elders, stood a lamb as though it had been slain, having seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God, which are sent out into all the earth. And then he came and took the scroll out of the hand of the right hand of him who sat on the throne. And now, when he had taken the scroll, the four living creatures and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb, each having a harp and golden bowls full of incense, which are the prayers of the saints. And they sang a new song, saying, "You are worthy to take the scroll and to open the seals, for you were slain, and you have redeemed us to God by your blood, out of every tribe and tongue and people and nation. And you have made us kings and priests to our God, and we shall reign on the earth." And then I looked, and I heard the voice of many angels around the throne, the living creatures and the elders. And the number of them was 10,000 times 10,000 and thousands of thousands, saying with a loud voice, "Worthy is the Lamb who was slain to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing." And every creature which is in heaven and on the earth and under the earth, and such as are in the sea and all that are in them, I heard saying, "Blessing and honor and glory and power be to him who sits on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever." And then the four living creatures said, "Amen." And the 24 elders fell down and worshiped him who lives forever and ever. But I just feel like God has made his presence so real here that we are there in that throne room, and we are actually able to witness this as God opens things up in the spirit to us. And it's just as like, this is the honor that we're given by the grace of God to be seated with him in heavenly places. And so just sense that in your hearts.
The scripture says that Jesus said that the kingdom of heaven is in you, that you are seated with Christ in heavenly places. You have to walk that out. You got to make that practical. You got to make that real in your daily life. That the next time somebody shares some bad news, you got to turn your heart and mind to the Lord and get a heavenly perspective. That the next time somebody comes to you with a bad diagnosis from a doctor, you got to look at that with a heavenly perspective. There is no disease in heaven. This song, these songs we're singing, Jesus said to pray in this manner. Therefore, in this manner, in this way, "Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven." That's people on earth asking God to do what is in heaven on earth. There's nothing natural about that. It's not just getting saved. He died on the cross for your sin, and by his stripes you were also healed. And so I don't know why our prayers don't always get answered. I don't know why we don't see more of heaven and earth, but we do know how to get there. It starts with asking, seeking, and knocking. It starts with believing that that's how it's supposed to be. I know every prayer isn't answered, but nothing gets answered unless you ask. And I know that he's going to rule and reign on earth in the future. But that prayer wasn't for the future. That was for today. So God, we ask for every gift that comes down from the Father above would be given to us, and that we would faithfully share that gift, that glory, that beauty, that love of Christ with every person we encounter. That we would encounter more of Jesus through the lives of other people who are coming to know him. That salvation would be in our homes, in our streets. That salvation would be in our schools. God, our children need Jesus. God, that you would give us favor in the school systems. That we would start having encounter nights in the auditoriums. That you'd give us favor with the administrators, with the superintendents, with the chancellor. Whether they know Jesus or not, God, that favor, unexplainable favor, be given to us to be in the schools in Jesus' name. To be in the Cortland City School Districts in Jesus' name. In Binghamton, in Auburn. That school doors would be open. That they would recognize that everything they've tried isn't stopping depression. It's not stopping suicide. It's not stopping cutting. Jesus is the answer. Give us favor with teachers. We pray in the name of Jesus that all Christians would find favor in positions of authority. That Christians would find positions on campuses. That Christians, that those who do not know you would be radically saved. Jesus, open a way where there has been no way in the past. We ask that you would show us the way forward for taking ground, for taking cities for Jesus. Show us where you're lighting fires. Show us where there is faith. Show us where there is favor. Show us where there is ground to stand. Places, God, where we can build. Places where you are laboring, God, that we would not labor in vain, but you would build your church and we would co-labor with Christ. Show us, Holy Spirit, where you have made room Show us what you are tearing down. Show us, Lord, those whom you are joining with us, who we need to partner with, who we need to believe with, who we need to do life with, who we need to minister with. Appoint your purposes and succeed where men have failed. Finish the work which you have started in us. Fill us with a burning passion, God, that will not be satisfied unless we trust and obey. We trust you, Jesus. You have a way. It's 9 o'clock. If you need to go, feel free to go. I don't think we're done yet. But if you gotta go, go with God, go in Jesus' name. Be a light out there.
you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working. Even when I don't see it, you're working. Even when I don't feel it, you're working. You never stop, you never stop working. You never stop, you never stop working.
Hallelujah. So praise God. Hallelujah. You are way maker.
Thank you.
Jesus, you're so good. Oh, you're so good. Thank you for your goodness. Flesh is so weak, but your spirit is so willing. So willing. So willing that none should perish, but all would have everlasting life. Thing that keeps coming to mind. I don't want to assume. I don't know what it is. Something to do with someone's mouth. And I'm particularly thinking about around the canine and your bottom jaw. If that means something to you, I'd like to talk to you in the back and pray with you. Sometimes it's 1 Corinthians 13. He talks about, he says, some he gives a word of knowledge, which is just information that you wouldn't know, shouldn't know, can't know. And so we step out and we explore and we just see if we can make sense of what God is trying to bring up. Experience has taught me that it's usually the Lord. And so if that's you, if there's something going on with your mouth, or something happened, or I don't know what, but I want to pray with you. How you guys feeling? Yeah. Pretty good. Anything else? Thank you. Lord, we thank you for tonight, for the honor of you showing up. For you being with us in our midst, because we gather in your name. You don't promise that just because we gather, you'll be there. You say that if we gather in your name, you in our midst. And so I thank you for showing up. I thank you for being near. I thank you for all the things that you've reminded us of, for the refreshment, for the touch of your spirit, for your nearness. Teach us how to keep that love relationship going. Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, God, Sunday would not be the time when we fill up, but it would be a time when we could actually pour out, because you've been with us all week, because you've never left us. You've never forsaken us. We have forgotten. We've gotten too busy. So I thank you for this night, God, for those who sacrifice time and money to come here tonight, for those other fellowships, God, that this would happen in their homes, in their places, in their cities, that you would continue to build on this into next year. Next year when we kick this off again, God, we just ask that it would be double portion experiences. That this team, that there'd be new worship leaders up here, that there would be new churches, that you would build your church however you like to do it. In Jesus' name, amen and amen.